Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video we are going to build weather application which will actually give us the weather information about a particular city. So we are going to use Redux Thunk, which is the middleware we have talked in the previous video. We will also explore what all other middlewares we can use, how middleware works, how to configure the middlewares while creating a store, and how to write actions supporting those middlewares. Okay, so this is a simple application we are going to write. In this application you can see we have a search bar and the weather information. Search bar we have and the weather information about a particular city. So currently we have two cities, like you got the weather of first city and then you got the weather of second city. You enter the information here, we are making an API call, getting the data, and we keep adding the data of that information in this weather object. So if you just see, we will also see the Redux Dev tool, what is the state we are holding, and whenever we are adding a new city, what is the update we are making in our Redux state. Okay, so we will write this code. We will write this code from scratch, and what we are going to do is, first we'll create a store, we'll create a reducer, we'll create actions, and we'll create a components. So if you see, we have only two components here, search bar component and the weather information component. Search bar is nothing but a text field. When you type something and click on submit, we will make a Redux action. That Redux action will make an API call, resolve the promise, will send the data to the reducer. Reducer will update the store. I mean, we will get a new state in the store. That new state will be able to publish here. Similarly, you will add another city, click on submit. We are going to make an API call using action creators, and we are already using Redux promises. So this API call will be made. Redux promises will wait until the API call is resolved. Once we receive success, we will actually pass this data to Redux store. We will get a new Redux state, and that new state will be published on UI in this weather list page. Okay. Very simple component. This component is talking to Redux, making an action call. This component, these both can be a container component. This component is just requesting a data from the Redux. So here in the second one, we are just going to use map state to props to receive the information. Here we are going to use map dispatch to props to dispatch this submit action to the Redux. Okay, so we are just going to create two higher order components, search bar and weather list component. It will read the data, it will trigger the action to the Redux store. Okay, and we are going to use a Redux dev tool. First of all, we will get a Redux promises. This is how we can get it. So here we are getting Redux promise from the Redux promises library. You just need to install it, and then you need to pass it in the apply middleware. So here we actually enhanced or customized this create store method. Okay, we just created a wrapper onto it. We are passing compose. Compose is taking two things, apply middleware and the Redux dev tools. This is what we have in the compose, and then we are calling create store method. So whatever we are getting, that we are using to create an actual store by passing the reducers. Here you can provide all different kind of middlewares. Middleware 1, comma middleware 2, all these middlewares you can pass here. Currently we have only single Redux promises which we are passing, but if you have a logger, then you can pass that logger here. Logger is also a Redux middleware, or any other middleware if you have, you keep passing it. So this enhancer will take a multiple middleware because it is using apply middleware. So all these middlewares will be applied in a chain with after one another. Okay, then this is the Redux dev tool, just to enable the Redux dev tool to inspect and debug the Redux state we have for this application. Now we can create a reducers, now we can create components, actions, all these things. So what we can do is, we can actually create our actions. Actions are pretty much simple. Here we can create a folder structure for that. Actions we have reducers, actions, reducer, and container component we have. Containers, and similarly the components. So if you see any Redux application, the folder structure is kind of same. Component will hold your the main component like app.js, which will have a search bar and weather list component. Container component will have your search bar, searchbar.js, and you can see weather list. Here we are actually showing some kind of a chart also. So we are going to use a chart library, which is just a predefined library we will use. Okay, we got component. Here we can create action. And we will also have a reducer. Reducer will be a weather reducer. And a simple reducer, which is a index.js. So in this index.js, we are going to create a root reducer. And this weather reducer will be just making an API call before sending this action to the reducer. So we are using Redux promises. Whenever we see a promise inside an action object, it will wait until this promise is resolved, and once we see the data, that data will be passed to the Redux state. Okay, so this is pretty much simple we have. Like, let's see what we can do is, first we will actually create a component. We will create these container components, then we will create the components, then actions and reducers. This is how our complete structure will work. So export function, get weather, you can say. Okay, this is arrow function. This is action creator we have written, right? So in the action creator, we will be using, Redux promises, we don't need to explicitly specify it. What we need is, we just need to make an API call. So here we need to have a weather API call, const, API key and all the other constants. So I will just copy and paste it. I already have created it, and we are going to make an API call with the help of Axios. So I will just add it. Okay, this API call we are adding, and here we have the action is, you can say const. We can export this const also, so we can use the same in the reducer, export const, fetch weather, and this is assigned to same key, fetch weather, and here in the get weather function, that we will be getting the city name. It can be a simple function, export function fetch weather. Let's create a simple function, and we will be passing the city name. So here we will be making an API call like const URL we are constructing. Okay, that will be some URL we will have, and we will actually make an API call, const request equal to axios dot get onto this URL we have. Okay, and here what we are returning from this, this is the action payload which we are going to send. Type is fetch weather, and the payload is the request which we have received. Payload is request. Now you can see what we are sending in the Redux action. This request is nothing but a promise, right? Here it is returning a promise. Request.get is returning a promise. You can see it is returning a promise. But before sending this to the reducer, Redux promise will actually wait until this promise is resolved. And whatever the resolved data we get, that data it is going to pass to the reducer function. Okay, now we will create our root reducer. Like, this is the one reducer, we have to combine all the reducers together. So what we can do is, we will create a reducers, which is like weather reducers, and one is a root reducer. In weather reducer, this is our action. This is our action creator. Now in the reducer, what we will do is, we will actually import the fetch weather, which we have created in the reducer, same fetch weather. Okay, from, let's do this, we have to go back again, actions, and here we are actually index, and what we need to import from there is fetch weather. Okay, now here it is a reducer function, sorry for this typo. export default function, and it is kind of, you can say that this is a reducer function which is initializing state with empty and action, and based on action what we are doing is returning the new state. Switch block we have, in switch block we are passing action.type, right? Based on the action.type we have a case. If case is fetch weather, then what you need to return is the current data, action.payload.data, okay, and the current state we have, just append it, right? So it's like we are not modifying the existing state, we are returning the new one, and in the default we can actually return the current state, or if this condition is not met you can just simply return the state. Okay, this is a switch block, this is a reducer we have created. Now we can actually create the combined reducer. So we have created index. So here in the weather reducer, we just remove this. So our reducer, there is a weather reducer, we have written the code. We can actually put that in the index. This index will go inside a weather reducer. And in the index.js, we can actually combine the reducer and we'll create a root reducer, which is a simple one. What we need to do here is reducers index.js. I mean, there is a duplicate of code we have written earlier. So this is our index.js. This is our weather reducer.js. Okay. And we are combining this both the we have a single reducer, but still we have to create a root reducer by using combined reducer, and this weather will hold the state. So whenever we need to get the weather list, we will be using state.weather. So we are done with our reducers, our actions. Now we can actually create our components. Our, first of all, we will create our root component, which will be nothing but simple two components we have. If we go to our component app.js, right here we will have two things only. We are going to create a search bar and weather list component. Search bar will be nothing but a text field on whenever you click on submit, we are going to actually make an API call through Redux actions. Okay, so inside container we will create a, we have search bar and weather list. This is fine. Now we need to create these container components. Search bar. So search bar is nothing but input text field, and on the on change we will actually capture the state we are getting. Okay, and whenever you are actually submitting or clicking onto the submit button, we will actually send the action to the Redux layer. So I will just create a component class search bar. It will extend react.component. I will first write the component now. So what this component will do? This component will have an interaction with the its container component, right? So how we create a container component? Export default, we will use connect. This component is not going to get anything from the Redux layer. So map state to props will be null. And then we have a map dispatch to props. Not like this. Here we have map dispatch to props. And the next thing is the component itself, which we are passing in the second argument. Now, this is what we are exporting. This component will be actually will be able to trigger the action to a Redux layer. So here I will be creating this function map dispatch to props. So we got the dispatch, and what we are dispatching is bind action creator. We will create a mapping of actions. Bind action creator, and here we are actually mapping the fetch weather and dispatch. So you can actually call props.fetchWeather. It is actually mapping, and same action we already have in our actions. If you see this src actions, we have already created this fetch weather. So this is action is getting mapped there with our actions which we have created. Now going to container component, search bar. Now you can write our code. Our code is nothing but a simple form. Okay, on submit we are going to make an action. We are going to just call a props. So our code will be something like this. So what we are doing, if I explain it in simple way, we have a term, and on input change we are updating the state. On input change we are updating the term, and on form submit we are actually calling this method fetch whether. You can see this fetch whether, we are actually invoking this particular method from to map dispatch to props, and this is again going to the actions. We'll see what is defined for fetch whether, and based on the fetch whether it will take these actions to the reducers. Okay, this is how it works. So we have fetch whether in the actions. From here, whenever you submit the form, it's very basic, it's React code, right? Form on input change, we have an on form submit. Whenever you click on to this input button type submit, it will call this method, and finally it is just calling this redux fetch whether and updating the state to empty value. Okay, so this is the one way, this is the one thing, search bar, right? Now we have another component, which is weather list. Weather list component will actually read the data from redux layer, because it need weather list, right? So how we do it, we'll create a class component. I will just show this example, right? Class weather list extends react.component, and same way we are actually going to create this as a container component. Okay, container component, how we create, export default, and we are going to use connect from React Redux. In the connect we'll pass map state to props is there. Map state to props, and when we don't have map dispatch to props, we can pass null, and this component we got weather list. Okay, so this component actually reading the data from the Redux store. So we have to write this function map state to props. Function map state to props. What we are doing is we are returning. So the first argument is actually a state. Okay, and what we are getting from this is weather and state dot weather. Or you can actually do the destructuring. Here you can pass directly weather, and this object will be then just we will be using object shorthand, and we can simply pass weather only. Okay, this is clear. So this is our map state to props we'll be doing. Now inside this component, what we will do is we will just check if we got the data or not. If we got the data, just render it. Okay, here we will be getting this weather information. Based on the weather information here, like here we'll have a render function. Inside render function you can just write your code, and here you can just use one render function. This dot, first of all we have to check did we got the weather information or not. This dot props dot weather, if this is there, then we can actually create our method. So this is actually an array, and we need to render the array elements. So this dot props dot weather dot map. Okay, in the map we are going to actually render some component. So this dot render weather. Okay, this dot render weather will be another function which we will be defining here, and based on the loop it will actually getting the city information. I mean, for every city it will be getting the weather data, and based on the weather data it will actually return it something like this. Okay, so this is how the consolidated data, we get the weather information, temperature, pressure, humidity, and same thing we are passing to the charts to just display this. Okay, rest all the other things are just displaying the data in whatever the way you want. We just focused on how we are actually communicating to the Redux layer to get the data. We are using map state to props, map dispatch to props, and that is giving us what we need, right? Here we are doing map dispatch to props to the Redux layer, and here we are using map state to props to read the Redux store. Okay, so this is a very basic example. We can see this running. Okay, in the next video we will just see the output whatever we have created in this video, and we will extend it using Redux thunk and Redux promises. Currently we are using Redux promises, but we will see how Redux thunk is different from Redux promises and how to use Redux thunk.